We are starting the expert talk. So good evening everyone. I am Harshal D. Kavade on behalf of team Rashtra Darshanam IIT Guwahati welcoming you all for the expert talk on self-reliant India today and tomorrow by renowned professor SP Bansal sir. What is our group, the Rashtra Darshanam? Is it is a organizing committee and team which is organizing various activities for social welfare in the vicinity of IIT Guwahati as well as northeastern region of India. Our team already conducted expert talk, tree plantation and conservation, cleaning drives inside the IITG campus, as well as cloth donation, bicycle donation, free education to the nearby underprivileged children and students, also supporting financially to some BPL families for their survival. This expert talk in one, it is like a one feeder to our social betterment of the surrounding society as well, binding IITG community together for the development of various sectors of today's India. Rashtra Darshanam also organized one agricultural tour in Konya village near Rongia of Assam, where we took 30 students of IITG from various backgrounds of scientific community, whereas they belong to different areas and states of India. And I am very much grateful to Professor Bansal sir for giving us his most valuable time in this period of pandemic. I would like to share a little brief introduction of Professor Bansal sir. Still, he is most renowned personality in Himachal Pradesh as well as in India. Currently, Professor Bansal sir is a Vice Chancellor of Himachal Pradesh Technical University, Hamirpur. He is former VC, former Vice Chancellor for Indira Gandhi Haryana State University, Mirpur, again in Haryana. And then he was again a former Vice Chancellor for BPS Nehru University. And then he is again former founder Vice Chancellor for Maharaja Agrasen University. So, Bansal sir has a very renowned positions. He has served to the country. Sir is professor in tourism department in Institute. He's a visitor nominee for Himachal Central University. Visitor nominee for Central University Tejpur, Assam. He is nominated for member of Board of Governors, BOG, for IITTM, Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. He is nominated member of Society and BOG of IIM. He is an expert member of Maharashtra Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan, advisor and visiting professor, University of Europe Tourism, Italy. And he is a member of University Planning Board Executive Committee in YMC, Haryana State Technical University. His principal is about different projects, as well as he is president for Indian Tourism and Hospitality Congress. He is chief editor for journals like Tourism Innovations, Tourism Spectrum, Tourism Development Journal, various newsletters, UGC nominees. Again, he is a UGC nominee for HRD Center in Punjab University, Patiala. He is chairperson for UGC Expert Committee. So, there are various feathers to his cap also. So, with this, I'll request Professor Bansal sir to please start with the today's talk. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Harshal, giving me an opportunity to share my views with just such an important audience. And I'm very happy that IIT Guwahati is doing really a wonderful job with regard to the social welfare activities through Rashtra Darshanam. That really, this is the need of the hour, which the IIT Guwahati students and the whole community is doing for the nearby villages and for the local community for social welfare. My appreciation to all for doing such a wonderful job and wonderful activities. Today, which the topic is given to me is just the self-reliant India, and self-reliant means that Atmanirbhar Bharat, and Atmanirbhar Bharat means that whatever the model we are looking forward, that India will become a superpower and India will become a Vishu Guru. For that, India has to be a self-reliant, and for that purpose, first of all, it is very important that we have to become a self-reliant. That is very important. And how we can come a self-reliant, that is important, and that is a matter of self-introspection for everybody. It means to become self-reliant ourselves, that it means it is very important to recognize ourselves, and by recognizing ourselves, so that we can come forward with the duty and actual meaning of the family, and through family we can have our duty towards the society and then towards the nation. As Mr. Harshal has already told, that already here the students are doing a lot of activities for the social welfare. Dear friends, my today's topic, I will divide the topic into three categories. Firstly, I would like to talk on, as already mentioned, is the trade and business. And through trade and business, how the India can become a self-reliant. And the second is that regarding the tourism, and with the help of tourism activities, how Bharat can become self-reliant. And third one is that, as everybody, we are passing through a very difficult phase of life, that is the COVID-19 pandemic, and this is a new normal for everybody, and we all don't know that how much time it will take to come across and to again reach on the after COVID-19 normal. And therefore, the different kind of technologies which we are using as an academician, as a scholar, and as a student, that is also very important. As an academician, we need to channelize our energy towards the innovative ideas, and daily, as a scholar, as an academician, we are trying to attend a lot of webinars to enhance our knowledge and our skill. From social media to e-learning platforms, through hackathons and webinars, all the stakeholders of education sector are doing its best to keep its flame ablaze. I believe that the problems such as the current situation are not the stop signs for all of us, and they just, what I consider, that they are the guidelines that will teach us, prepare us, and help us to become more stronger.
Chanda ke phone leke bolo.
Now the whole world is looking towards India, towards Bharat. As when our Honorable Prime Minister was talking about the Atmanirbhar Bharat or self-reliant India, and he was delivering a speech on 12th May, and he was trying to resonate in the Indian minds in resemblance to his call for Make in India, which was initiated in 2014. And when I was I was comparing with both these two campaigns. The first one is the Make in India, which was started in 2014, and the second one is the Atmanirbhar Bharat. These two have many similarities, and the biggest similarities are that both Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India are great ideas, but sometimes are misinterpreted in due to the vested interest, or maybe due to the lack of communication and lack of understanding among the public. Therefore, it is very important just to know about that, how we can see the future of our this great country as an Atmanirbhar Bharat, as a Vishwa Guru, and for that purpose we have to change our mindset. We have to change our thinking process. Maybe when we will come out of this new normal, we will see many new things in after post COVID-19 normal. I feel both visions are correct. They are conceived of at two different points in time, and Make in India was launched just to give, to boost the manufacturing sector, the industry sector, and the self-reliant India package of rupees 20 lakh crore, which was announced for reviving and ailing economy in the post-lockdown scenario in the midst of the siege of COVID-19. And Make in India was launched to spur up productivity and employment generation capacity of a fledgling manufacturing sector by creating a business friendly environment that will help the private investment as well as also the foreign capital. On the other hand, the self-reliant India move made clear the dual objectives the package would serve: to revive the declining Indian economy through fiscal measures and to make economy self-reliant, particularly in this new normal and after this new normal. Rather, what I consider the Make in India's vision was to promote the foreign investment in India by making the nation a favored destination through improvements in its ease of doing business. And on the other hand, the need for self-reliance is going to be realized in the near future. Dear friends, self-reliant India should be constituted as a means to create a robust domestic economic system through investment as well as consumption demand. But at the same time, this does not preclude the foreign investment, and without creating a congenial business environment, it is not possible. And that's the reason that our Prime Minister, while reiterating the ambition of the $5 trillion economy for India and talks of the package focus on four parameters he has given: land, labor, liquidity and laws. Everything must be more simplified, which he emphasized. And further, he reiterates that the call for self-reliance is a progression of Make in India. It has been shown in various researches that a well-developed sustainable development goals, SDG, maybe while we talk about various states and particularly in the northeast states regarding the social, physical, natural and human capital which are embedded are better indicators of the business conditions. And on the self-reliance goals, however, the resource allocation has been improper, and this is more so because whatever the finance minister recently announced, what we can see as a motivated factor towards looking at boosting the supply side through the maybe easing of loan, maybe with the help of short-term fiscal incentives. As a economic analyst, we can say to some extent she has overlooked the demand side variables. And this gives the impression that the supply creates its own demand. Is prevalent? Is true? If yes, how? India tried to plan to convert COVID crisis into an opportunity, because this is the crucial time and this is the challenge for everybody, and the time to convert this time into an opportunity and further into our target goal. Self-reliant India will be realized by, again, given with the help of five parameters, that is based on economy, based on better infrastructure, based on the system, based on demography, and based on demand. And it is therefore time to become vocal for local products and make them global. Because in this time when we have seen that most of the marginal workers, they have shifted already from the urban to the rural areas to in the villages, and but I believe that it may be possible that the 40 to 50% workers can come back in the urban, but I'm visualizing that about 50% workers will remain there, and therefore whatever the policy we are preparing, that must be that labor intensive, labor oriented policy which we have to frame to revive this manufacturing sector. It means if really India has to become a self-reliant, India has to become a Atmanirbhar Bharat, then again India has to convert all the villages into the manufacturing hub. That is very important. And under this campaign of the vocal for local and ultimately to convert it at a global level, under this campaign a special economic package which was announced and released by the government will benefit, maybe for the time being, for this crucial time, will be benefited for the cottage industry, will be benefited for the micro, small and medium enterprises, will be benefited for the laborers, will be benefited for the middle class, will be benefited for the industries. But at the same time, to strengthen the self-reliant India campaign, Atmanirbhar Bharat campaign, the land, labor, liquidity and the laws have been emphasized in this package is need to be simplified, need to be improved. And the mission is to make in
make India self-reliant in key economic sectors and improve to come out of this future economic shock. Now, healthcare is the sector where in this crucial time, in this new normal, India tried to become Atmanirbhar, where while COVID-19 has acquainted India to the fact that the domestic innovators can develop high quality healthcare solutions at par with the global competitors, whatever we also have seen nowadays. And moreover, these solutions are usually adopted for local conditions and are significantly more affordable. For example, in fact, we can see that the record expansion of the PPE manufacturing industry in India from almost non-existent local production to now the world's second largest producer. Now India is producing more than 5 lakh PPEs per day is a clear indicator of the India's untapped potential, which shows that India has a lot of potential. Now the whole world is looking towards India. COVID-19 pandemic should be taken as a template to streamline operational processes and build preparedness for such future pandemics. And for an Atmanirbhar Bharat, the government is focusing on primary healthcare and improved facilities at the grassroots health institutions, and steps are also being discussed to enable the preparedness for future pandemics, such as the separate hospital blocks for the such kind of infectious diseases and stronger and integrated the lab networks. And the more important is that whether we can consider it just a start of journey in the process of becoming Atmanirbhar Bharat, or this is the sign of to become India as a self-reliant, followed by the Vision Guru very soon, which we have all seen a dream of Vision Guru Bharat. Self-reliance in state-run heavy industry and strategic sectors in the decade, and while to go in the little past, and I have seen the journey for Bharat to become a self-reliant, and when I was comparing that the self-reliance in the state-run in the industry and strategic sector in the decade following independence had placed India ahead of most developing countries. And in the 70s and 80s, India did not modernize these industries to climb higher up the technological ladder. Maybe little effort was made to modernize light industries or develop the contemporary consumer products. Maybe the India's industrial ecosystem was thus characterized by the low productivity, poor quality and low technology, and was globally uncompetitive. This was a first lesson for India and a step move forward to become a self-reliant. And India completely missed out on the third industrial revolution, comprising electronic goods, microprocessor, personal computers, mobile phones, and decentralized manufacturing and global blue chains during the so-called lost decades. And today, India is the world's second largest smartphone market. And at the turn of the millennium, when India embarked on liberalization, privatization, and globalization, and the very concept of self-reliance was, we can say, the rubbish, and in the belief that it was tantamount to reinventing the wheel when advanced technologies could simply be brought from anywhere at the lower cost. and at the taste two related ideas have prevailed since then and neither delivered the desired results. And the first was the public sector undertaking are by definition the inefficient and sluggish for the competitive globalized scenario, and no effort was made at that time to stimulate either real autonomy or end transition to new technologies direction. And instead, public sector undertakings with capability and scale for the task were undermined and embodied at that time. And on the other hand, the private sector displayed little interest in this heavy industry and shows no appetite for technological upgradation. And with the entry of foreign corporations, most Indian private companies related and reiterated into the technology import or collaboration. And today, whatever we can see, and we can see that we have seen that now this motto of the vocal for local and but no snug to globalization can be possible. And the another idea was that the inventing foreign direct investment in manufacturing by foreign majors would bring new technologies into the India's industrial ecosystem, obviating the need of indigenous efforts towards the self-reliance. And the countries like Thailand, like Malaysia, like Indonesia and Vietnam have focused on offshore manufacturing, lower down the value chain and without the thrust on self-reliance. This is useful for job creation, but is an unsuitable model for a country of India's size and aspirations. Again, China is, of course, unique in scale and in its determination to become a superpower, not just geopolitically, but also in self-reliant science and technology and industrial capability. Now, the China advanced purposefully from low-end mass manufacturing to a dominant role in global supply chain, and it has now decided to shift into the advanced manufacturing and set itself a target of becoming a world leader by 2035 in 5G, in supercomputing, in Internet of Things, in artificial intelligence, in autonomous vehicle, in biotech, in pharma and other technological of the fourth industrial revolution. But now India has taken lesson, and every developed countries, even USA, even Japan, even other developed countries, now they have taken a lesson, and now they are pushing behind their hands from China, and they are shifting their industry from China to the other place, and now but they are planning, and they are thinking that India is the best place now in the world to shift all kind of these industries from China to India. But unfortunately, whatever the India has missed the bus in many of these technologies in which the US, Europe and China have established perhaps the impossible leads, and they have to make the possible from impossible, and yet self-reliant capabilities in electrical and in fuel cell vehicles and electricity storage systems, solar cells and modules, aircraft and artificial intelligence, even in the robotics, in the automation, even the biotech, in the pharma, they have to take a lead. And finally, India's mega public expenditure on education needs to be substantially ramped up as against current trend for privatization, which would only shrink access and including in skill development. And all we have seen the NEP, National Education Policy, new policy which has come up, and whatever we have seen, whatever the changes they have made and whatever they have proposed, that at least India has to spend 6% expenditure on the education of the GDP. That whatever the recommendation in the National Education Policy they have given, and these recommendations, if really implemented, if the 50% of the recommendations given in the new education, National Education Policy implemented, even then it will be sufficient to become India as a self-reliant, to become a Vishwa Guru. Even in the agriculture sector, a large proportion of the Indian population is dependent on agriculture, and the majority of which is made up of small and medium farmers. And when I was looking for the gist of the export when the world in the World Economic Forum, where our Honorable Prime Minister has given the opening remark, and the, where the President of USA, Mr. Trump, has given the closing remark, and whatever gist I was reading, that they have distributed and they have put the different countries into the three driven economies. First one was the innovation driven economy, and second was the efficiency driven economy, and third was the efficiency and factor driven economies. And they had put India into the factor driven economy, and my surprise was not why they had not put India into innovation and efficiency driven economies, but the gist of is that the very soon India can enter into the innovation and efficiency driven economies, but India has to concentrate on the vitality and vibrancy of the higher education. They have to revive its old legacy in terms of the agriculture, in terms of the education. Because the senior professor, Oxford University senior professor Angus Madison, has written in his book that very soon India will revive its that economy, where in India's the GDP was about 31% in 1000 year to 1500 of the whole world GDP, and it has come down and reached to about 3% when we become independent. And when we become independent, at that time the agriculture GDP was the 54%, and the service GDP was the 17%. Now the reverse, which we can see that kind of paradigm shifting, that is suitable for making India as a self-reliant, that is also again big question mark. And when we also discuss regarding what kind of infrastructure it is required to become a self-reliant and to meet the target of the $5 trillion micro economy by 2025, be self-sufficient, become a global manufacturing hub, and growth of infrastructure is the key factor. And with 65% of Indian population residing in rural areas, rural infrastructure really need to be upgraded to ensure the basic amenities to the rural population. And innovation again is the main factor, and innovation will have a major role in accelerating India's growth story. And the nation can leverage its existing skill and innovation base in healthcare, agriculture, education, and infrastructure to help the fast track the creation of resilient, self-sufficient new Bharat. The global pandemic shows us the benefits of be Indian and by Indian. It is more important that even that we become self-reliant and reduce our dependence on other countries. The pandemic has taught the importance of local manufacturing, has taught us the importance of local market and local supply chain, emphasis of vocal for local asserts that it is all about made in India, and is to increase, to push Indian products to become large enough to become international brands. Dear friends, ultimately, a self-reliant India will have to stand on 5 pillars. That is economy, which brings in quantum jump and not incremental change. Infrastructure, which should become the identity of India, of New Bharat. Technology-driven system, vibrant demography, and demand. Our Honorable Prime Minister has given the 5 I's to make India self-reliant economy. The first I, he has given intent. The second I, he has given inclusion. The third I, he has given the investment. Fourth I, he has given the infrastructure. And fifth I, that is very important, that is the innovation. But we can achieve all these five I's only with positive beliefs, because your positive belief will be converted ultimately into your words. Your words converted will be in a action. Your action will be converted into your habit. Your habit will be converted into your values. Your values will be converted ultimately into your
थोड़े देर बाद
destiny.
चाहे दे दे.
Your positive beliefs
दे दिए हमके.
Your destiny. Therefore, you can achieve everything, but you have to self-recognize yourself that what is your contribution towards the self-reliant India, self-reliant Bharat. This is just a temporary thing for the revival of to make Atmanirbhar Bharat, and just for the revival of this in the new normal in India. The government has brought in the major reforms in the various sectors, just as the labor reforms, just as the agriculture reforms, just as the allowing private companies and strategic sectors and commercial mining of course, etc. With this measure, the government is hopeful that the fundamentals of Indian economy will be more inclined towards growth. But this is just to come out of this temporary crucial phase. But more important is that the businesses, including MSMEs, though the recently definition of MSMEs was revised by raising the investment limit and an additional criterion of turnover was introduced, and secondly for the poor, for the including the migrant and farmers. That they have to make such a policy. So for these poor, including the migrant and farmers, and special policy is needed for agriculture. Special policy is required for the new horizon of growth. Although the government plans to introduce the competition, transparency, and private sector participation by revenue sharing mechanism instead of regime of fixed rupee ton and entry norms will be liberalized. But even to become a self-reliant, India has to concentrate on the mineral sector. India has to concentrate on the defense sector. India has to concentrate on the aviation sector. India has to concentrate on the power sector. India has to concentrate on the social infrastructure sector. India has to concentrate on the space sector. India has to concentrate on the atomic energy related reforms. India has to concentrate on the special kind of move for the employment generation. India has to concentrate on the healthcare sector. India has to concentrate on take a special move out of this national education policy for the education sector. Dear friends, हम सबको ऐसा लगा कि lockdown के बाद जब हम unlock तीसरे चरण में प्रवेश हुए तो जिंदगी को पटरी पर लौटने का हम सब ने प्रयत्न किया, बट एट दिस क्रूशियल टाइम जो मोदी हमारे इस सरकार का फोकस घरेलू बाजार पर होना भारतीय अर्थव्यवस्था के लिए शुभ संकेत था, इसके लिए वोकल फॉर लोकल के साथ आत्मनिर्भर भारत की बात जब कही गई थी तो आत्मनिर्भर भारत की बात कोई नहीं थी, और वास्तव में यह विचार जो है हमारे महात्मा गांधी के ग्राम स्वराज की अवधारणा का ही एक नया स्वरूप था। गांधी जी हमेशा गांव को स्वावलंबी बनाने के लिए कुटीर उद्योगों को बढ़ावा देने की बात करते रहे हैं। आत्मनिर्भर भारत का तात्पर्य है दुनिया के साथ जुड़े रहते हुए आर्थिक विकास के साथ अपने लोगों के जीवन की गुणवत्ता सुधारना और भारत के भविष्य का पुनर्निर्माण करना। तो अगर यही लक्ष्य है, उन्होंने पांच पिलर बताए, इकोनॉमी, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, डिमांड और सिस्टम एंड डेमोग्राफी, तो क्या 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 इनको जब व्हेन ऑलवेज आई टॉक अबाउट ऑल दिस फाइव पिलर्स व्हिच इज रिसेंटली बीइंग अनाउंस्ड बाय आवर ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर, एंड व्हेन आई कंपेयर इट विद द फाइव सीज, दिस फाइव सीज आई हैव गिवन, द फाइव सीज always which I talked about, first is the commitment, second is the concern, third is the cohesiveness, rather seven C's I will talk about. First is the commitment, second is the concern, Third is the cohesiveness. Fourth is the coordination. Fifth is the contemporary. Sixth is the creative. And seventh is the compassion. These seven C's, which we have to align these seven C's with the those five I's, as well as this five pillar of the economy. Only then we can realize the that model which we have seen in our dreams of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Dear friends, the second part which I would like to take is regarding tourism. Although it's a very important sector, and post and COVID-19, the travel and tourism industry, like many others, will never be the same again. Most affected industry is the travel and tourism industry. This means that we cannot go on business as usual. Private public stakeholders in the tourism industry, both locally and internationally, will have to rethink a lot of their practices. जब आज की डेट में एयरलाइंस बंद हैं और इंटरनेशनल की एडवाइजरी जो जारी हुई है, एडवाइजरी के मुताबिक अभी वी कैन नॉट थिंक अबाउट द इंटरनेशनल ट्रेवल एटलीस्ट फॉर 2 ईयर्स. आज सब होटल्स बंद हैं, सब ट्रेवल एजेंसीज बंद हैं, टूर ऑपरेटर्स बंद हैं. देन इट मीन्स इट रियली दिस इज द टाइम टू रीथिंक for the practices of the hotel industry, for the practice of the travel and tour operators, and what measures can adopt to retrieve the industry once this crisis blow will be over. In India, travel and tourism industry contribute to around 8.1% to India's employment, or 42.7 million jobs. And one, as per one of the assessment, as per KPMG, a multinational professional services network, it is expected that about 10 to 15% of these jobs will shrink. And this was an assessment which this agency has made before 2 months. Now the situation altogether is different. And four of the top 10 countries, we can consider the China, Germany, the US, and the UK, that contribute to about 60% of the foreign tourist arrivals in India. Feature among the top 10 countries reporting the maximum COVID-19 cases. And similarly, the top states contributing to domestic tourism, both in origin and destinations, are impacted. And these states may be the Maharashtra, we can take Kerala, UP, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Tamil Nadu. These are the top states which are contributor of the domestic tourism, domestic tourist inflows. Therefore, the real question for tourism industry is that how much will be the demand and supply, and how much travel demand will come back after this new normal. The important question is that how much time it will take to return it to the pre-virus level. The important question is that will demand pattern, including the split between the business and leisure travel demand and other tourism forms, be different than before. The important question is that how will the entire travel experience, from shopping for services to the quality of service delivered, be different than before? Dear friends, the answers, all these questions are interlaced, because all the factors that figure into the formation of demand, price, capacity, and the perceived value of the various aspects of the travel experience are all highly variable, as well as intricately intertwined and interdependent. But one thing though is for sure, that travel demand will return back in a greater speed. The main challenge before us to revive local tourism immediately, because we have to think local, be vocal, and become global. Therefore, the immediate challenge is how we can revive local tourism to revive state and regional tourism, followed by the revival of national domestic tourism, inbound and outbound tourism. Although ICMR recently issued sort of advisory not to travel abroad, at least in the next 2 years, and nationally in another 1 year, provided it is most important. Dear friends, change is the nature of life, but challenge is the aim of life. So always challenge the change, not try to change the challenge. Sometimes we build too many walls, but not enough bridges. This is the time to build enough bridges. This is the time to adopt the innovative strategic approach for reincarnation of tourism and paradigm shifting from over tourism, over consumption, and excessive greed to alternate tourism. Maybe with the help of product innovation means that we have to find the new destinations, we have to find some kind of accommodation with the new advisory, we have to think about some new kind of food, some new kind of transport. We have to go for process innovation, that we have to evolve the new ways of making tourism popular. We have to go for some kind of logistic innovation. That is, we have to evolve the new ways of supplying products and services of the tourism sector. Or we can go for the market innovation, that we can evolve some kind of new ways of marketing and consumer behavior of tourism sector. World sees a major shift in habits today. It has also given us the opportunity to slow down, reassess priorities, and reflect on how travel will change in the near future and why it will still matter. Dear friends, this is the testing time for all of us, and that how can we change this opportunity to boon with positive attitude to find ourselves in a win-win situation in the time to come. Now, when we are planning for the alternate tourism, that kind of alternate tourism can be the wellness tourism, that kind of the alternate tourism can be the medical tourism, that kind of alternate tourism can be it means now we have to concentrate on the allocentric kind of tourist, that we have to prepare that kind of destination for that kind of tourist and tourism. Now the exotic tourism we can promote. The real ambassador of tourism, which I always consider, is to our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji. Narendra Modi ji jahan bhi gaye, उन्होंने टूरिज्म को प्रमोट किया, इंडिया एज ए डेस्टिनेशन एज ए ब्रांड प्रमोट किया। उन्होंने कहा कि 25 मिलियन एनआरआई बाहर रहते हैं, उन्होंने कहा कि कम से कम हर एनआरआई को एक बार, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट टू प्रमोट द एथनिक टूरिज्म, उनको एक बार अपने ग्रास रूट, अपने इंडिया में, भारत में आना चाहिए। उन्होंने इंडियन से अपील की कि एटलीस्ट आपको, यू हैव टू विजिट एटलीस्ट द 5 डेस्टिनेशंस, आप एक 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 पीरियड में कम से कम, स्टार्टिंग इट फ्रॉम योर बर्थ प्लेस, क्योंकि मैं दावे के साथ कह सकता हूं कि अभी तक जितने हमने बर्थ जहां लिया है, हमने गांव में लिया है, व्हेन वी हैव माइग्रेटेड इन टू अर्बन, हमने पीछे घूम करके अपने बर्थ प्लेस को नहीं देखा, तो राइट इट फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग अवर बर्थ प्लेस, वी कैन प्रमोट, वी कैन विजिट एटलीस्ट द 5 डेस्टिनेशन, हम वहां पर जाएं, फोटो क्लिक करें, इनक्रेडिबल इंडिया लिखें, वो फोटो जो है हम अपने फ्रेंड्स को भेजें, पोस्ट करें, फेसबुक पे दें, इन दैट वे वी कैन प्रमोट इंडिया एंड दिस विल हेल्प टू बिकम इंडिया एज ए सेल्फ रिलायंट, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। डियर फ्रेंड्स, देयर इज lot of uncertainty, and the future is unpredictable for the whole world. It is the real time for all of us to reinvent our policies, to reinvent, to rethink the business and trade, travel and tourism for the sake of the people and planet. Nature has given us a second chance to rethink our trajectory. Work and recreation must be restructured and layer reconfigured to prioritize well-being and equity and the long-term sustainability of the world rather than just profit and ambition. हम प्रॉफिट की बात बाद में भी कर लेंगे. नाउ द इंपॉर्टेंट, मोर इंपॉर्टेंट इज अवर सर्वाइवल एंड देन रिवाइवल. एंड वन थिंग इज वेरी क्लियर, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू लर्न. आई एम ऑल्सो इन द बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर ऑफ द आईएम एंड वट एवर आई हैव सीन, आई एम रियली वेरी हैप्पी दैट आईआईटी गुवाहाटी इज डूइंग अ वंडरफुल जॉब इन टर्म्स ऑफ द human being, in terms of the social welfare. Dear friends, let us stay put, let us stay home today and dream for tomorrow, for new Bharat, Atmanirbhar Bharat. Thank you very much. And I have also, now it is almost the time is over. And the third portion which I have given you, that nowadays that this is again a real challenge, that how we can use a new technology as an academician, as a teacher, to give, to reach to the students, and that kind of the digital initiative in higher education taken by the MHRD also, that the national mission on education through ICT means empowerment of students and teachers through the synchronous and asynchronous instructions, and that for that purpose we can use the SWAYAM portal, we can use the SWAYAM Prabha portal, that for that purpose we can use the NPTEL portal, for that purpose we can use the virtual labs, for that purpose we can use the FOSI means the free, libre and open source software in education system, and for that purpose we can take the help of the national digital library, that is the NDL, and now this is the that how the teacher can in a best manner to reach to the student by using this kind of technology. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It is really a great talk. It's for India, for self-reliant India. The brief benefits in trade and business explained by you will be helpful for most of us to understand the new era which is coming after this COVID-19 pandemic. As explained by you, the trade and businesses, what are the PPA kids production, is a new area which is under this COVID-19 period. Then what is required for agricultural sector, the innovation driven economy and efficiency driven economy, how can achieve that, then five pillars of economy, then five I's and seven C's explained by you. These are the key points which we can take it out from the talk. And then the travel demand, it is like a very happening thing and a very thing said by you, sir. And then it is really a great advice to you, this challenge to the change, and it is very much important in nowadays for all of us. So thank and be grateful to all of you for listening to this national eye-opening talk by Professor Bansal sir, and I hope you all enjoyed it listening. And if you wish to join our team or you want to ask any question regarding this talk, then please forward your questions to rashtradarshanam.iitg@gmail.com. Once again, I'm thankful to Bansal sir for his expert views regarding self-reliant India and the future perspective. I am thankful to one and all for cooperating with us, and I urge you all take care of yourself in this pandemic. We will also organize such talks in near future, so kindly join with us in near future. Thanks again.